In my previous video, I had explained how strings are stored in the memory and how strings are terminated with a special character and what is the purpose of that termination character. Here in this short video, we will study all this in details. Let me explain you what is a string. So string is an array of characters. That means multiple characters makes a string. For example, Canara Engineering College. Generally, we do not show the special character at the end of the string, which is used as termination character. But you have to understand that every string is terminated with that particular special character, but we do not write it during explanation. Before studying what are ASCII numbers, let me explain how data gets stored in memory. We know every data is stored in the memory in the format of binary numbers. If we have a hexadecimal number or decimal number or octal number, we have various methods to convert that data into binary and we can store it in the memory. But if suppose I ask you to store a character capital letter A into memory, you cannot convert it into binary in order to store it. Can we store a character as it is in the memory? No, we can't, because memory is arrangement of cells where each cell can hold either 1 or 0. So a character cannot be stored in the memory as it is. It should be converted into binary. We do not have any particular method to convert any character into a binary data because characters are not numbers like hexadecimal, decimal or octal. Every character is assigned to a unique number, and whenever a character has to be stored in the memory, instead of character, that unique assigned number is considered and that assigned number is converted into binary and stored instead of the given character. Such assigned number is called ASCII. ASCII numbers are standard numbers. That means every character you see on the keyboard or use in any programming language, there are numbers assigned to all these characters. A unique number, ASCII number, is assigned to these characters. And standard in the sense, these numbers do not change worldwide. For example, the ASCII of capital A is 65 in decimal. That means this is true all over the world. Every character you see on the keyboard, whether it is a number, whether it is an alphabet, small letter, capital letter, or special characters, they are assigned with an ASCII. You can refer ASCII table in Google to understand what are different ASCII values for different characters. One thing you should know, that every ASCII number is 8-bit in nature. That means every character is assigned to a single unique ASCII number, and that ASCII number is 8-bit or 1 byte. That means, I'm indirectly saying, every character takes 1 byte in the memory. This you might have studied in various different languages also. For example, in C, we say the variable character takes 1 byte data in the memory. That is because every character is assigned to ASCII and that ASCII is stored in memory. And every ASCII is 1 byte or 8 bit. Let me explain you how a character is stored in the memory using ASCII. For example, let me take a character C, capital C. The ASCII of capital C is 67. 67 is in decimal. I can convert it to hexadecimal. It is 43H. Or to binary, where I have written that value here. When I write down ASCII value in binary, I have written it in 8 bit because one ASCII number takes 1 byte of memory or 8 bit in the memory. So now how exactly the character C looks like when it is stored in the memory? It exactly looks like this. Here 1 byte. Because 1 byte is 8 bit and 8 bit ASCII is written instead of capital C. Or sometimes we represent it using hexadecimal, that is both are equal way of representation. If it is hexadecimal, I will write a 43H or 43, where 4 takes 4 bit and 3 takes 4 bit, total 1 byte of data. Now let us see how a string is stored in the memory. Now string is nothing but multiple characters. So we represent every character of the string with its equivalent ASCII number. For example, there is a string called academic, written in capital letters. Now, how that academic string is represented in ASCII? That is nothing but it is again array of ASCII of every character in the string. I have written every ASCII in hexadecimal so that I can easily convert it to binary while storing in the memory. Now, ASCII of A is 41 in hexadecimal, ASCII of C is 43, ASCII of A is again 41, so on. This is how we store, represent a string using ASCII numbers. By representing every character of the string by its own ASCII. Now, how exactly string is stored in the memory? It depends on the endian format, because there are two different ways to store a data in the memory: a big endian format and a little endian format. This is we have studied in previous videos, where I had given many examples by taking different numbers as data. Today we will study how strings can be stored in memory using either big endian or little endian format. Let me explain the big endian format and how a string can be stored in the memory using ASCII through big endian format. Here is the string academic and its equivalent representation in ASCII. Now, how this academic string is stored in the memory? According to big endian, the MSB byte occupies the least address available in the memory, and the LSB byte occupies the most or maximum address available in the memory. So here my memory starts from zero, right from address zero, my memory is free. So I'll keep data in the memory starting from address zero. Here you can easily see that my word size is 4 byte. These are the word addresses and these are the byte addresses. I cannot show byte address of every byte here. So I have shown only for first row. Now we know that every ASCII is 1 byte. There are 8 characters here in the academic string. So there are 8 different ASCII. So 8 different ASCII means the data is 8 byte, nothing but 2 words, because my words processor word size is 4 byte. So how do you store 2 different words in the memory when a single word is 4 byte, but my entire data is 8 byte? I have explained already this for a hexadecimal number in my previous video. We take first word, that is nothing but first 4 byte or nothing but first 4 ASCII characters, because every ASCII is 1 byte. This is word 1, and I'll consider second word nothing but last 4 ASCII's. This is word 2. So initially we place word 1, then we place word 2 in the memory. Here in the word 1, this is least significant byte, that is ASCII 44, and this is the most significant byte, that is ASCII 41. So according to the big endian format, most significant byte must occupy the least address available. So 41 comes here, then 43, and then 41, and then 44. Similarly, we go to second word now. There are 4 bytes again here, and this is the 43. This is the least significant byte here, and this is the most significant byte here, that is 45. So again we follow big endian format. The most significant byte 45 at the least address available, that is 4. Then 4D, that is next byte, then 49, that is the next byte, and finally the least byte 43 at the maximum address available, nothing but 7. So this is how a string is stored in the memory using ASCII numbers. Whenever I say 41 is stored here, 41H, that is 41 hexadecimal, actually its binary equivalent is stored, but I cannot write binary for 8 bit binary for every character, it becomes very lengthy. That's why we use hexadecimal numbers to represent binary data in the memory. So if you look at this, here I have represented every memory using hexadecimal characters. This is actually placed like this, like first word and second word. So this is how academic looks like. But make sure you understand that in this address there is no capital A. Actually there is only ASCII of A stored in the form of binary. But writing ASCII, writing binary is a big hectic work. So I have directly written here, capital A, capital C, or what are the characters. So whenever I say there is a character in the memory, actually there will be binary of ASCII equivalent to that character. So this is a way of storing strings using Big Endian. Now let us see the Little Endian format. Again, I will take same example, the string academic. Now how to represent it in ASCII, you know it already. Now how Little Endian works? Little Endian format is completely different than Big Endian format. In the Little Endian format, least significant byte sits in least address available and most significant byte sits in most address, maximum address available. So let us see this example. Here there are two words. Again, we know that this is the first word and this is the second word. Okay, word 1 and word 2. So we'll consider word 1 first. Here word 1 first, this is 44 is least significant byte and this 41 is most significant byte. We know how to find out this. Now according to the Little Endian definition, least significant byte, that is 44, must occupy least address available. Then 41, the next byte, and then 43, and finally 41, most significant byte, which is stored in the address 3, which is maximum address available right now here. Then we go to word 2. Here also 43 is least significant byte and 45 is the most significant byte. So least significant byte goes to least address available, that is 4. Then 49, then one more byte, 4D, and finally most significant byte, that is 45. So this is how 2 word or 8 byte string is stored in the Little Endian format. See, we know this already. Okay, we had 8 byte hexadecimal number here. We know how to store 8 byte hexadecimal number. We have studied this in previous video, Big Endian as well as Little Endian. Here only difference is this 8 byte hexadecimal number is derived from a string using ASCII technique. That's it. So this is the same concept. You should able to compare this with the previous video concepts, where we have stored a 8 byte regular hexadecimal number. Here also it is an ASCII is nothing but here is an 8 byte hexadecimal number only, but it is derived from a string using ASCII concept. That's the extra thing here. So this is how the characters of academic strings are stored in the memory using Little Endian format. Okay, when we represent it in character. So I'll repeat again, when I say here there is a character A is stored, the character A is not stored. The binary of ASCII equivalent to character A is stored. This is how a string is stored in the memory. Here is one more string. This example I have taken from your prescribed textbook. Here the string itself contains 8 characters and characters are nothing but the numbers. So there is a little bit confusion you may go through. Listen carefully. As my previous example, this string also contains 8 different characters. So these are not numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. Here it is considered as characters. That's why we have written it within double quote. So now how to represent this number into hexadecimal? That's using ASCII. Every character has ASCII. Do we have 0, 1, 2, 3? Do 0, 1, 2, 3 have ASCII? Yes. If it is considered as a character, they have ASCII. The ASCII of 0 is 30H in hexadecimal. The ASCII of 1 is 31. The ASCII of 2 is 32. You can refer ASCII table. Again, I am telling same. So don't get confused. This is a string with characters. There are 8 characters. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How it is stored in Big and Little Endian format? Again, I don't go for that complicated procedure of converting into hexadecimal and then a binary, all those things. Okay, I'll simply represent given character as it is. So here is a Big Endian assignment. So we can consider this first to four characters, because every character is represented using ASCII. Every ASCII takes 1 byte of memory. So every character indirectly takes 1 byte of memory. So first to 4 byte I will represent it as word 1 and next to 4 byte I will represent it as word 2. So initially we store word 1, then we go for storing word 2. Now in word 1, the 0 is most significant byte. It is a character, so most significant byte. and 3 is least significant byte. According to Big Endian, most significant byte sits in least significant address. Means 0 sits here, this address, then 1 sits here, then 2 sits here, and finally 3 is stored in this. Then we go to second word here. We know that 7 is least significant byte and 4 is most significant byte. So we store 4 first, then 5, then 6, and then final least significant byte 7. So these data inside every cell is characters which are going to be stored in memory when applied Big Endian format. These are not memory addresses. Don't get confused. He has not shown memory addresses. He has only shown word addresses. Now in Little Endian format, we have to store least significant byte in lowest address available. So let us consider the first word here. Okay. In first word, again, 3 is least significant byte. 0 is the most significant byte. According to Little Endian, 3 first gets stored here in first address, then 2, then 1, and then 0. Last most significant byte. Then we go to second word. In second word, 7 is the least significant byte. It gets stored first. So here 7. Then followed by 6, followed by 5, and followed by 4, which is the most significant byte, which gets most address, right, maximum address available. So this is how he has explained in textbook taking this particular string. So this was a short video where I have explained what are string, what are characters, what are ASCII values, how strings are stored in memory as array of characters using ASCII for every character. Thank you.